Hello, it's Michelle again, and I just wanted to finish up our couple weeks of lithic analysis by showing you a real-life FSN lithic assemblage. So this is all the lithics from one excavation unit, so 10 centimeters deep, of a 2 meter by 2 meter unit. And this is all the lithic material that was found in that amount of soil. And a lot of times we would find more lithic than this, but at this particular site, it doesn't have a lot of lithic material, so this is a pretty good amount. And so I just kind of wanted to show you the things that I look for when we're doing a lithic analysis. And it takes me much longer than this video allows, but I just wanted to give you a quick overview of what I'm looking for. So the first thing I look for is flakes. Are there flakes in there? And there definitely are, and there are flakes from a couple of different chert types. So we've got a Crowley's Ridge flake, and it has no cortex on it, so I would keep that in a pile by itself. And then I've got probably Crowley's Ridge flake, but it does have cortex on it, so that's it was taken off earlier in the process than that previous one, so that might go in a different pile. And then I have some lithics that are, this is just a pebble, it's not worked at all, it's just a river rock. Someone picked up and brought to the site, but it was never actually used. And then I've got some other chunkier things that this has a few flakes taken off of it on this side, but when you turn it over, it's just really shattered. It's just all broken up in here, very rough. So I'd call this shatter, and it might be shattered because of fire, because of heat, and it would be then be called fire cracked, but it's not necessarily fire cracked, but it's definitely just broken in no specific way. A lot of times fire cracked rocks, you're going to see something called potlitting, and you can kind of see it on this guy right here. Not sure if you'll be able to, this camera isn't great. But potlitting is essentially you get these little circles that pop out of the rock, and the circles themselves kind of look like a potlid because they're a little bit domed, and then you're left in the rock, it's left with a concavity, a round concavity. And so you can kind of see a couple on here. And then also in this assemblage, this is an interesting one because it does have a piece of a biface. So you can see that it's flaked on this side, and it's flaked on this side as well, and it's got a base, and it's fairly thin, but the tip is broken. So this one, we would note that it might be a preform of something, or it might be some kind of knife, and we could take some measurements on the width of the base and the thickness, but being that it might be a preform, the thickness might not be very conclusive, but it gives us a little bit more information about what kind of points they were making at this site. So that's very interesting. And then we get this bigger rock that you'd think might have really been used for something, but it's only got a couple of flakes taken off of it. And really some of these flakes could have been taken off by a plow somewhere in history. It's tough to tell when a flake was broken off of something necessarily. And so then we've got just some other bits and pieces here. We've got some Lafayette gravels, so just kind of different non-Crowley's Ridge, but not identifiable by me. They were probably just river rocks that people were getting out, so they could have come down from the Lafayette formations further north into Missouri. And then we've got kind of a more crystalline rock. And those don't flake very well, so this one is really just kind of broken. And really, yeah, that's kind of about it. That's the big things we look for is there cortex? Is it a flake? Is it fire cracked? Is it some kind of produced point, a biface of some sort? And then is it utilized or was it completely unmodified? And then what sort of rock type was it? So I hope that's kind of gives you a sort of idea of what we're doing in the lab here when we're looking at lithics. And then I wanted to share this book that I think is a good resource for different point types in the mid-continental and eastern United States, as it says. And some of them we would never find around here, but a lot of them we might through different time periods, and I just think it's a good kind of starting reference point to think about different point types and how they're categorized together based on different characteristics. So I hope that was interesting for you, and I think that kind of wraps up our talk about lithics. And next week we're going to start talking about faunal analysis. So I hope to see you back here then. Talk to you later. Bye.